Hey everyone, how are you today? I sure miss being with you more often than I can, but I'm so busy, guys, so I apologize. I hear some awful good stories out there, how you guys are really doing well. This is a long journey here, and I promise you I'll get to that video on love either this afternoon or this weekend. And I want to keep this camera set up, Drew, over the weekend here. Hopefully I'll get to it this weekend. I'm trying to get the class put together and everything like that. And a couple of things. I thought I'd we talk about balance, and of course some of you guys are really getting out there. I mean, one guy was telling me that they were doing the oranges, and they've gotten up to these higher levels and have been proving all these things we've been talking about, and it's true. I'll tell you. So just be careful with the balance thing, but it's fun to journey into these higher realms of health and healing and to see it, because it registers, it changes the mind. Of course, it changes the body, it changes your spirituality. So just keep up with that and keep working with that. On the other hand, I was looking, someone was talking about Dan McDonald this morning, how he's now going into high fats. That guy, David Wolf, kind of did the same thing, You have to be careful, guys, with high fats, pumpkin spam, pond scum, which is algae. People think algae is so good. These are proteins, and these are single-celled organisms. And don't spend your money. Just go find a lake that's stagnant and suck the scum off of it. I mean, it's the same thing, whether it's Klamath Lake, it doesn't matter, Corella, spirulina, blah, 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 it doesn't matter. But you see, the problem is man's seeking his answers everywhere but in front of him. It's like the Ponce de Leon was seeking the fountain of youth, and he was looking all over for the fountain of youth here in Florida. And his horse was eating on it all the while. I mean, it's you've got to realize the answer's right in front of your face. And I think that Dan just needed to come back and balance out a little bit, But going into a high-fat diet, dangerous, that when you're malabsorbed and you have liver and hepatic problems, you are going to have problems with oils and stuff in terms of deficiencies, maybe, if you want to look at it that way. But when you fix your digestion and you fix your absorption, then you're going to do well with your fruits and berries and melons. And you bring yourself down to some salads if you want to for balance. But to sit there and go on a high-fat diet, and this is the pendulum we talk about. And you see this, David Wolf did that. He was a purist, and then suddenly digestive enzymes, probiotics. Then they did that at Hippocrates. These people are 50 years behind the times, I can tell you. Or I'm 50 years in front of the times, one of the two, because tell you the truth, we get people way out there in vitality and health without palm scum and without all the high fats and stuff. Gotta look in nature. Use nature as your barometer, not the man's intellect. If you use man's intellect and academics as I've been trying to show you here, you'll get confused. And if you think for a minute that man's intellect is superior somehow to the creator, I would suggest narcissism. Because that isn't the way it is. Nature's where it's happening. Nature is the living, breathing example of how the Creator set everything up. And when we talk about laboratories, this is the largest laboratory we have access to. Not our little laboratories in these pharmaceutical companies or in universities. We're just playing. It's a game here. Remember, this is creation. And so it's the game. We play our little chemist game, we play our little games. But if you want to know truth, you have to look beyond the game. And that's what we're talking about. Someone sent me some, what were they throwing up or something? All these worms they were throwing up. Can you get a picture of those
worms? Yeah, they returned from Mexico.
Mexico.
And ever since, they've accumulated the parasites.
Yeah.
But we're talking larger
guys want some
parasites.
for breakfast? No? No worms for
Let me
breakfast?
zoom in.
Zoom in. No parasites for breakfast. Protein. If you're going to eat palm scum, why not eat parasites? I mean, they're all protein. I don't know what people. All right. Here's another thing we're going to talk about this morning. This is just going to be a quick video, by the way. And then this afternoon, I'm coming back, and I think you will try to. We'll try to get all these eye pictures. If not, I'm going to come in and answer all these questions. And EGLE 107. Honey, you wrote me a lot of questions, sweetheart. I mean, page after page of questions. I don't know how much I'm going to get to that. And that's another thing. I invite you all to read books. And here's the other problem, though, with reading all these books is you get confused. But get into the natural hygienic books. Get into some of these books that really get into proper food combinations and things like this. Use your common sense. If fruit doesn't combine with anything, then don't try to combine it. You know, someone was saying that all these raw food books, you know, they show these salad preparations and they throw fruit in there. Just because someone writes a raw food book doesn't mean they're real savvy on all the aspects of raw foods and food combinations. That's the problem with a lot of these books. And so you have to, you know, this I kind of echo what the head of the American Medical Association said to Wally, I think it was Wally Safer, one of the 60 Minutes guys, when they were on to him about medical doctors that hurt other people and moved to states and keep doing this. And the head of the AMA at that time said, "Let buyer beware." Wasn't patient, wasn't individual citizen, wasn't anything like that. It was like, buyer beware. And that right there spelled that out. If you can find that, that's probably 15 years ago, but if you can find that old 60-minute interview, you'll be shocked at what the head of the AMA says. Well, that just says what his consciousness of the AMA is, and of course, medical doctors are going to exude that consciousness. You know, that's just the way it is. So that's what you have to do. You guys have to get knowledged up. Use common sense. You know, if you're suffering, realize there's a process to getting well. And sometimes that process is long, it's hard, and we just want to give up and go find something to take that'll fix us. There is nothing out there to take it to fix us. Go back to all those years you suffered and all the things you took. And we're just seeking that one thing that'll make us feel better, and there isn't. Because if you get too much, like Dan is in oils and he feels better, but now he's going to go for the crash because now the liver's stressed. Matter of fact, that's how we detoxify the liver from stones, right? Is we spasm the liver with a liver gallbladder flush. And what do we use? Oils. Too many oils will spasm your liver. So you have to be careful about going too far on either side. Balance, guys. That's why I teach balance. And a lot of you, which is good now. I'm not being down on Dan or anybody else. I'm just saying that in front of your eyes, you're seeing the different aspects, and you're seeing some of us get out of balance, some of us come back into balance. No judgment. It's the way it is, and this rock spinning through space. But just for you guys, try to stay balanced. Don't do the David Wolfe and Dan McDonald thing where you went from one side, the purest side, and then you flipped way over to another side. Walk with balance. If you want to add fats in your diet, okay. Add them in, but don't make that total. Because if you look at someone's supplements that come in, they have on a lot of oils. And oils are the most toxic part of plants, by the way, and that's FDA, not me. And I believe that. That's why essential oils in this country are only allowed external use. Germany allows some internal use of essential oils. Anyway, what I want to show you this morning is called kinesiology. And I was in partners with a chiropractor for a long time in the earlier years. He graduated from Palmer, and I graduated from Brantwood, and we came together. We were in Ekankar together, and we liked each other right off. And so we taught classes because we were just graduated. We didn't have any clients. And so he went into another practice with another chiropractic group, but he needed his own clients. So we taught classes together for years, and he was kinesiology, and I was detoxification and herbology. And this is, now they have different names for it now. This was called Touch for Health years ago. And they have all kinds of names for it now. And I'll just give you some ideas here. Here's some points on the back. I'm going to show you these points that you can touch, that you can work on, because some of you that are having serious lymphatic problems need to do this on yourselves. It'll be really helpful. It really increases drainage here, so of the lymph. So I'm going to show you that, and we've incorporated the help of Matt. Now, the reason you guys get your herbs on time and good is because of Matt here. Matt is a head of the shipping department and all-around good sport. Are we going to do this over here? Mm-hmm. Okay, so I want to show you some things that you can do to help yourself out in stat emergencies. This is Matt. And how you can help yourself in emergencies. And unfortunately, Matt, you're going to have to take off your shirt. Yep. Now, girls, Okay, now let's turn him, Matt, around first, and I want to show you this. Now, you got that, Drew? Matt's got a spine running down through here like everybody else. And you'll feel up here, a lot of people go, oh, my shoulders are stiff and tight. Like, Matt, you feel that right there? Mm-hmm. You're real tight and stiff. So on each side, not down the, not on top of the spine, but on each side of the spine, especially between the ribs as you go here, but on each side of the spine are called neural lymphatic points. And that's just what they are. They're neural lymphatic points. They stimulate lymph nodes and lymphatic drainage through the nervous system. When you're playing with frequencies and magnetism and everything, there are certain directions you want to follow to maintain strength and directions that can actually weaken. So when you're working on somebody and you're trying to get their lymph system to drain, especially when you're tight in the head, you're tight in the shoulders, thyroid is low, things like this. And we teach this in class, so I'm not going to get too much into this for you on the YouTube, but you want to start up here. And it's on each side of the spine, not on the spine itself, as I said. And what you want to do is take your thumb and feel where a person is real hard. And you want to go clockwise. You want to go clockwise and you want to work down this spine. Because each one of these neural lymphatic points relate to lungs, relate to kidneys, relate to all the tissues, like reflexology on the foot. And you work this all the way down. And where you get down into the kidney. See, now I'm getting down to your kidney. See that? Feel that? Yeah. That's just kidneys. And so what we're going to do is boost his filtration up for the day. And what this will do is help him drain. And you can work him right on down. You work him right on down. You can work him right on down into some of these real hardened areas that have a hard time. Feel that? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Same thing. You want to get on this side too. You can use both fingers like this. See that, Drew? You can use your knuckle, but you don't want to hurt them. And a lot of times they're going to be real sore. So what you want to do is start out slower and work it out of them. Work it out, work it out, work it out, work it out. Work them down toward the kidneys here. They're going to be sore in the kidneys. A lot of people are sore in the thyroid, which is located up here. And you can boost them for the day in the thyroid. Now, if you go counterclockwise, you'll weaken them. You will weaken that respective tissue. You could use that technique in hyper cases, hyperactivity. You can start at the neck and work these spots down. I had a good friend. He was you're stuck right in here. I had a good friend who was Jensen's first patient and lifelong buddy. They go down in the Philippines and they filmed psychic surgery where the guy went in. And boy, I saw the film and the stories were incredible with him and Rudy. But Rudy was a naturopath. And he could take 2 points on the body and I could feel my lymph literally draining. He was so smart about how the body works. So this is important to do, especially for those that are if cancer and fighting lymphatic drainage problems, work on these points. Now, I'll turn you around and I'll show you some more. These are a little more painful, so I'm not going to do it. But if I was a chiropractor, sadists, are we? Good. So these points are a little more sensitive, and they're on each side of the rib there where it comes in. Here's the sternum and each side of the ribs, and you get in there and you go clockwise again, and you can work that out. And you just go right down this sternum here just like this, and you work it out. It can get real sore. Right under here is one that can get real sore. Real sore. And this is especially true when you're having heart problems, heart palpitations. You're having a heart attack. Work on the foot. That'll pull you out of the heart attack. Work on these areas here. Much more painful here. So if you do that, thanks, man.
No problem.
Yeah. So if you do that, you'll help open that flow of lymph, and it'll be really good for yourself. Okay. Thanks. I appreciate it, Captain. What's your phone number now? No. That's just a simple demonstration of kinesiology. If we had more time, I would show you how to weaken a thyroid. And you can use, remember that video we have on muscle testing? Yeah, baby. What you can do is go to the thyroid gland on the back, and you could rub it. You could have them hold their thyroid gland like this. And I think we even just demonstrated that, didn't we, where we can weaken the thyroid and increase that thyroid. Well, this is the kinesiology, and I would do it on everyone, especially when you're tight and stiff or you're fighting cancer, you're fighting anything involved up in here, breast tumors, tumors on the neck, head,
congestion,
yep. Everything. You break that channel, you open up that channel down that spine, and that'll open that up. So what are we going to do? We're going to do some eyes here.
Yeah.
So you want to cut this one a little? Well, let's go ahead and prepare, then Chris can cut this right there.
I'm going to have this cut. Yep, right now.
Okay, right now. Cut. Oh, wait, I got to say bye.
Oh, yeah.
Say bye.
Then we're going to cut.
Yeah, and then we're going to do some eyes here, guys. So say bye. Bye, Drew.
Bye, Dr. Morris.
Bye.
I'm going to keep this on.
Okay.
All right. I'm just going to move your chair.
Oh, look at all these, man. Oh. Look at all these.
We love eyes.
Oh, we love eyes. All right. Matter of fact, we can open this up by looking at eyes. Holy crap. Oh, man. I don't know about this one. But let's open up with this one. This is really a big one. I don't know who this is, but... Oh, Danielle, darling. Right. Oh, my God. Okay.
Just let me know when you want go live so Chris will know.
Okay. This must be the right eye. Yeah, this is the right. Okay. So
now,
let's.
All right. Chris, in 5 seconds, I'll count down, and then you could do the.
Okay.
You can start at that point.
Okay.
5, 4, 3.
Look, I don't have any light
here. 2, 1, 2, 3. We are live.
Alive. We're live. It's live.
So we're back.
We're back.
How you doing?
We're back. Hey, Drew.
I haven't seen you for a minute.
All right. Well, there you go. Oh, I think I'm losing my battery over here on this one. All right, guys. We're going to go through some eyes here, and I'm just kind of going to go through them, so I apologize for not taking my time. I've tried to do that on other videos about the eyes. Again, this is iridology, the science discovered by a surgeon in 1853. The surgeon discovered that these fibers, which are on top of the rods and cones, these fibers directly are connected neurologically through the optic nerve to the hard drive, the brain. The brain, being the central nervous system, then is connected to the body through the parasympathetic nervous system and the sympathetic nervous system. Central nervous system is just like the computer hard drive. All the information is stored. All the directional information is there. The autonomic nervous system is that nervous system that makes everything happen, makes everything move, makes you breathe, makes your heart pump. The sympathetic part is controlled by the adrenals, and the parasympathetic comes right out of the cerebellum. For those that have dizziness, equilibrium problems, things like that, it's at the cerebellum.
Brain fog,
right. All those things. About stomach problems? Because all these two nervous systems come together in the stomach.
Yep.
So you can get nauseated from having pressure in the head. And when you get pressure in the back of the neck and head, that's the cerebellum. Your blood pressure can flip. You can get equilibrium problems, dizzy problems, and that's that value of that kinesiology to work on that. So this is a right eye. Obviously, you see all this orange around the pupil here. This orange is sulfur, heavy sulfur, antibiotic use. This yellow could be an aspect of that, or she's moving in or he's moving into a subacute stage. Remember, there's 4 stages of disease, if you want. You can call it disease, and if you're looking at it medically, but other ways, there's 4 stages, actually, that you're going to see tissue move through. Toxicity move through, and that is called acute, subacute, chronic, and degenerative. We talk about these a lot more in the class, but that changes the color of an eye. This yellow can be what's called a subacute stage of weakness in a blue eye. This white is acute stage of weakness, and then brown in a blue eye is a chronic. Outside of that, wherever you see black, See a little black around, immediately around the pupil here? Mm-hmm. Black means decay. There's decay, the tissue's getting burned by acids, and in this case, the stomach is getting burnt a little bit here. But you got this high sulfur content, that's a gas, a bloaty gas. It also can feel burning in there, and then you have your normal cellular acids. Sulfur is such a glue that it glues in the lymph system. You get a malabsorption ring, which is a brown ring around the pupil. The skin ring on this person is gigantic. See how dark this is around the outside of the eye? And here's this person's left eye. I think a better light source would be better, but you're beginning to see how dark this is around the border here. Out the outside of the eye, the skin wraps around the body, then it wraps around the eye, and that's where the skin is found. And this is a huge skin ring. In terms of these fibers, when these fibers, and we showed you this on other videos, but when these fibers are nice and straight, that's strong cells. And these fibers represent cells. All this white and yellow and orange sits on top of the fibers like a cloud over the landscape. The blue sky is underneath all this white stuff, and the cells are depicted by these fibers. You want to zoom and show them that? Here's an Irish chart that was done by a naturopath in New Zealand, and I just really love that guy. This is a beautiful chart. I really like it. We sell it at the class. You can buy it through the pharmacy, but I think they're like $25, but it costs us about $20 to get them here. But look at look at all that. That's beautiful. It really shows you where the organs and glands. There's the kidney and adrenals. Here's the bladder. So you begin to really see what we look at, and we look at that through these fibers that are in the eye here. Yeah. So we have that. And then there's the skin on the outside of the eye. You should never see a differentiation between this outer border of the eye and the fibers itself. You shouldn't see a darker ring around here. When you can see a darker ring, the skin is weak. And chances are they're not sweating well and not eliminating well. Well, if you don't eliminate out of the third kidney, and you certainly aren't eliminating out of the two other kidneys, where's all that cellular sewage going? It's building up, absolutely. And those are serious cases when the skin is not filtering along with the other two kidneys. That's problematic, big time. And this is a case where you might see that. The fibers are fairly straight here. Yeah, this is the right eye. So we got a leg weakness here, straight down 6 o'clock. We got a knee going on here in this case. Kidneys are backed up lymphatically. See how thick that is? Got a little adrenal up there going. Then we have, if this is the female, probably the vaginal wall right here, or the male, the prostate. Bladder's got a lot of acidosis in it or inflammation, and some of this dark here could be part of the bladder.
Because of the sulfur accumulation within the system, toxicity, the nerve rings are very faint.
See, that's another thing is these nerve rings, Drew. Good point. See, these nerve rings, you see them here, but they are faint. And whenever you see a ring in the eye like this, immediately no adrenal glands, because the adrenal glands controls the autonomic through the parasympathetic side, without neurotransmitters, you'll lose your nervous system. Of course, and that actually shows up. I find it quite interesting that as your nerve energy or your myelin sheath start to lose its magnetics and its viscosity and all the good stuff about health of a cell, it starts to ring the eye. And you'll see these are called nerve rings, or what they used to say, cramp rings. And this is the autonomic to me, not the autonomic nerve breath. I don't believe in that. I think the way to look into your autonomic system is through these nerve rings and the adrenal glands right here. Here's the throat weakness right here, and here's a little parathyroid weakness right here. A lot of mucus in the thyroid there, maybe even nodules, who knows? But that stomach area, all this needs to be cleaned out. For the most part, it's a pretty strong person here. This is in the bronchial trunks right here, just for information. But this is all around the right lung pattern here. So this person really needs to dig in and get their skin to open up. This is a real dark, dark skin area. It's real dark as far as I'm concerned. Could just be the lighting or the picture. This is lighting up pretty good, but this person needs to revitalize their body. Now, Let me see. Thank you, Bernard Jensen. I've had many years put together beautiful, simple. Oh, thanks. Could you please look at my eyes? I have chronic lupus. Have emailed you before, and I'm following your advice. Thank you. I've been raw juicing. Okay. So let's look at this case here. This is the right eye, of course. Now, you see all these blood vessels? This white is the sclera. And there is a science called sclerology. It's been around maybe at least as long, if not longer, than iridology. So this is a book on sclerology. Can you see that, Drew? Mm-hmm. And you get into these different, what each of these different blood vessels mean, because they each go to organs and glands. You know, when you look how God made the body, it's amazing how everything reflects everything else. And what it shows, and remember how you tie one on and you got real bloodshot eyes in the morning, because it brings high acidosis. And this is a sign of high acidosis. But this line and everything is pointing right at that dark spot right there. And that dark spot is the throat and could be part of the upper neck on the right side. And there's a little breakdown of that either neck or throat right in that area. And you'll see that's kind of where this big one is headed. It's pointing. It's almost like it points to it. Mm-hmm. This is going right up here to the thyroid gland. And right there is parathyroid thyroid gland weakness in this case. If you move up, looking at the endocrine glands for a minute, look up here, big time parathyroid. Pituitary. And this is probably pineal right here, meaning this person might have a hard time sleeping. You see that little sulfur around the bowel? Now, these aren't as lit up as much, but they got the sulfur right around the pupil. This is common because of the world of the allopathy and the use of antibiotic sulfa drugs. So if this is a female, we have vaginal wall weakness. This person needs to douche with some Hill-All tea. If it's a male, that's the prostate area up there. Need to get that kidney filtering, and there's that little line of the kidney. This right leg on this person is weak too. And this is what you're classically going to see. When you see kidneys, long-term weakness through genetics on kidneys, what do you lose? Hips, knees, things like that. And that's what you see in eyes. And that's the beauty of using eyes as research and correlation, because you can see thousands and thousands of eyes, and pretty soon you start correlating this. It helps you to understand more about what we're talking about. And the eye work is just perfect. For a practitioner, I highly recommend you get into the iris work. It'll make your life so much easier. And you don't have to be a rocket scientist about anything. This is the groin area here, and we look at here's the hip, just what we were talking about. Here's the right hip, and here's the pancreas, the ovary or testicle, and now we have the gallbladder involved as well, and maybe some of the liver. Mm-hmm. So this person has to get into the bowels, clean them up, get into the liver and the pancreas. Matter of fact, I would, to keep it portable, I would alternate between a liver formula, liver gallbladder formula, and a pancreatic formula. With that said, you got to get this a kidney and adrenal filtering and get these hips and things hooked up. Now, another thing that I've noticed through the years is whenever we see more bony structure problems, not only do we look at the kidneys, we're going to come up here and look at this parathyroid gland, because you start to see the weakening of the structure, believe it or not, when the parathyroid gland is weak. Matter of fact, you'll start seeing all these fibers starting to get disarrayed. Now, this is all bronchial trunk over here. Got some congestion in the lower lobe and mid lobe of the lung here. This is getting up toward the right ear area. A lot of congestion in the sinuses. See all that congestion up there? That's sitting on top of the bowel. That's why when you clean up the colon here, the sinus can drain. And I think that another, what iridology teaches us, is the vital link between the colon, how it surrounds the eye here, and how it relates to every single thing in the eye. Dr. Jensen talked a lot about that, of course. He was a freak about that, but so was N.W. Walker. And they had different charts, of course. I do have to say that in talking with Jensen a lot, Jensen, I prefer his chart because he was an iridologist. So he knew the eye quite well, and that would relate better. It would fit better. But I'll have to say, for someone like N.W. Walker, it was pretty good. I lived to be 107. There's stories of 109 and things, but Jensen, nice. That was Jensen's personal friend. Mm-hmm. But Jensen said he didn't see them the last 10 years of his life, so don't know. Now, that's the right eye. The left eye, you're still seeing some of these blood vessels come in up here. This is right again, right at the throat area, coming right in the throat. And this one's going down to this dark area right here. Now, this is the back. And this is mid-back, so there's some problems developing mid-back. Well, if we have problems developing, what could develop or what could make the back break down? Acids in the lymph system, always going to go back to the system that deals with the corrosive side of chemistry. Blood rarely breaks you down long enough before it kills you. So this is lymphatic issues. You see the thick white here around this area, this dark area, probably a genetic lesion there. It is heading toward the lower back, of course. So what, should we look for kidneys? Well, look at that big dark area. This person has a much bigger kidney weakness on the left side. Here we're picking up a knee again. Here's groin again and moving to the left hip again. This is up to the left breast area here, that little area right there. Probably shoulder, left shoulder here. This is in the mastoid. Here's in the cerebellum up here. So here's a case that could have equilibrium dizzy, swinging blood pressures. There's a lot of lymph up there. See that thicker area there? And could have problems with that. A little bit of pituitary here on this side. Thyroid looks a little better here. A little bit of a skin ring, not bad, just a little bit. See how you can see that little skin ring that we had? This is tonsils. Okay. Thank you for submitting that. We probably are not going to do much more than these on this site because we've got so many other things to cover. And
those are
now,
nice. Look at that.
Please be my Santa this year. That's cute. That's cute. Please advise me. My mom is panicking, saying I have leukemia and making me eat stuff that I know is not good for me. Uh-oh. Okay, so this is a problem. And this is the problem that I'm having here, guys, and I just need your help. That's why the Facebook sites are so valuable here. You guys are such a value to the world. I have a hard time. This has been sitting here in this thing for quite a while, and I just now got to read it. And I don't know how long this has been here. This problem is this. The sad thing is in medical world and leukemia and what they do with leukemia. And I don't want to show any. I'd just like to show a picture of that little girl that died from chemo. Treating leukemia with chemo is about as is. I don't even have any words for that. If I was a judge, I'd march that doc into jail for about 10 years because you cannot treat leukemia with chemo. That's why you get leukemia in the first place is chemo, meaning acids. That's why you break down the bone marrow. That's why you see your white blood cells go up or down. I'll say this, if you have elevated white blood cells, great. What you don't want is low white blood cells because if your bone marrow isn't producing enough white blood cells, you're in trouble. And the same thing with platelets. If platelets aren't being produced in the bone marrow properly, you also clean the spleen. If you have low white blood cells, you've got to really get in there and work this out. High white blood cells, your body's fighting. You've got a lot of lymphatic problems. And of course, then you're diagnosed with lymphatic-induced leukemias. And why we would ever use chemo, I just think that we are so out of balance right now that there's got to be some serious changes. Because too many kids are dying from leukemia, from just an issue that's easy to rectify. Blood is so much easier to rectify. Blood conditions are so much easier to rectify than lymphatic conditions because of the nature of acids, the nature of dehydration, the nature of the body's need to be more on the base side of chemistry to keep corrosiveness and things like this to a minimum. That's obvious. And I don't know why. These are simple, obvious issues that all medical doctors A1A1. All right, so looking at this, you still see this person has a lot of these bloodshot eyes, these blood vessels here. This, of course, is a right eye here. You're looking at the bowel wall. Now look at this. I'm going to show you this, and this is the colon on this side of the pupil. Now look at the design of the colon. It balloons out here, comes in, balloons out again, comes in here, another little pocketed area right here, maybe a couple little pocketed areas, kind of balloons out. Here's the hepatic flexure, which should come up here a little bit, but look at how this dives down. After you come over this hump of this mountain, which is the, again, hepatic flexure, the curve in the colon, it dumps down into the valley, meaning this is highly prolapsed. And drop down. And when you start to see a prolapse and ballooning, that's connective tissue problems. Where do we find connective tissue problems? Parathyroid gland. And we come over here and what we see? Thyroid, parathyroid trouble. Right there. See all those little patterns there? And remember, patterns is what we're looking for. When these fibers are nice and straight, that means the cells are nice and straight. The cells are strong. I use the word George Burns. But when you see patterns, that's a weakness. And Jensen used to say in these weaker areas genetically, there was compromised blood and lymph. I could never speak to the blood side of that, but I can speak to the lymph because right around this thyroid lesion or lacuna, which is the name we give these patterns, you see that white? See that white surrounding that? That white is lymph stagnation, meaning that this is a genetic weakness, that the lymph system is even further compromised and not moving well out of that. So then you start having polyps or you get a goiter. Oh, let's take the thyroid out. I mean, that's insanity. We got to bring our consciousness up because there's a lot of stuff going on this planet. Holy crap. This is the mid-back here, and this is relating to this blood vessel. See how that's pointing right at this area right here? That's mid-back. Here's a lymph node swollen or two in the back. We come down here, of course, we're on the kidney area, leg area, and groin area. You see a lot of activity, a lot of weaknesses going on in this. Kidney, leg, groin. And then this bowel is ballooned out here, putting pressure on the hip. And then we move here and we see the pancreas and then the ovary or testicle. You see this little bit of a skin ring around here? See that little bit of a skin ring?
Very minimal.
Yeah. And then we're getting into the lungs here. And this is mid-lobe. We need to clean those lungs out a little bit here, clean the bronchial trunks out. A lot of congestion up in the ear, the shoulder, and the eye area here. All this white you see in this blue eye is lymphatic in origin. I'm going to have Shannon follow up on this one. Find out what's going on with her. Again, you see this thick white? See how that thick white is? It looks like it's a cloud on top of the eye. See that thick white? That's lymph. That has to be cleaned out of there. That's inflammation, if you want to use a medical terminology, or I think a more appropriate word would be acidosis. And if we can get using the word acidosis in replace of inflammation, we're speaking more appropriately and more pointedly of what the problem is. This is getting up in the tonsils up here, and again, you see this tonsil here creating inflammation in the tissue here. Now, I don't know if that tonsil's been removed or it's just weakened or what. A lot of lymph in the thyroid, parathyroid area, and in the throat area. A little bit of weakness in the throat area. Now we're starting to get into upper back weaknesses, and here's lower back weaknesses, and more kidney, leg. See how all that is? Moving around to the female male. All of this, here's some rectal wall weakness. But these are strong eyes, and even though we're going and it sounds like a lot of things, believe it or not, this person has strong genes. They can get in here, clean up all this kidney, get all the thyroid cleaned out, get that lymph moving, get the skin refurbished, and change the texture of their eye.
So you would say a strong constitution?
Yeah, I would say a fairly strong constitution. Yep. Not the best, but certainly up there good.
And it can get stronger.
Oh, yeah, so yeah. This person can clean their body out well. To think that, and the trouble is, moms, if you push your daughters and you think they have leukemia, you better read these videos, because if not, a lot of the moms, not knowing and not realizing and pulling the panic button, their babies are under the ground right now. Because medical doctors, they don't care. They don't care anymore. And it's just, it's crazy. Now, I'm not saying all medical doctors. Let me say that back. Because there's some great medical doctors out there now learning the truth, and I respect Absolutely. Those guys tremendously. Mm-hmm. But those guys that are continuing to insult tissue like this is nuts, and they need to be lose their license, because this is ridiculous what they're doing to these kids. And these kids can come out of leukemia pretty easy if they did have that. So you have to be careful, parents, about doing something to your kid you're going to regret later. And I've got a lot of stories for you. The kids are now sucking up dirt because they did the wrong thing. And the problem is, in this country, you don't have a choice. So that's why it's so important to get your kids healthy and get yourself healthy, because if your kid's diagnosed with cancer, you just lost your kid out of your hands. If they survive, which would be very rare, 6%, remember that, then you're okay. Well, that's for 5 years, and then you lose your child later on. Hey, it's all insane. You guys have to learn this. You moms that have serious trouble with your babies, you got to learn how to get them well, or it's a sad thing. It's a real sad thing. We see it here every day. There's another side of this clinic, and that is all the tears that are shed out here for what we see coming in here and what's been done to them by the allopathic community for the sake of what? I didn't get that. For the sake of what? Health? Is that what you're claiming? I mean, this is ridiculous. Nice eyelashes, though. Look how long her eyelashes is.
I must say that the eye photos that have been coming in are just amazing.
Well, is it that?
But they're getting better every time. Well,
you know what? Because these students, these YouTubers,
I love that.
These guys are on their game. And that's what I love about these guys. And it is my opinion, and of course, you can call me kook if you want, but it's my opinion that it's because of all these YouTubers now that the world is going to turn itself around.
Yeah, but the quality.
Yeah. Everybody's getting smarter. And that's the truth. Just keep yourselves balanced. Don't try to jump too far. If you feel like you need a supplement, get a superfood blend out there. Be careful about digestive enzymes and probiotics. This is the crap that's circling around. Remember, if you take digestive enzymes, you'll lose your pancreatic ability to digest your foods in time. Probiotics, why are you messing with lactobacillus and bifidus group? If you want to clean your lymph system out with probiotics, go eat rotten meat. Remember the story about the Northern Alaskan elder that fed that young man rotten meat and cleaned his lymphoma out? Now, those are the bacteria you want. Those are proteolytics. Hungry meat eaters.
I was going to ask you earlier, when you were talking about the parathyroid gland.
Oh, yeah.
Extensive use of probiotics. Can that damage in the long run?
I wouldn't think so. I would think that man's gig is the fear of bacterium, but yet they just want to add a lot more in there. And I think it's ridiculous when we start using our minds to try to find our way to health, because it already is quite simple. It's established through nature, and we just want to keep taking things and not working the health back out of the body.
Get the root cause.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. And I understand that, because some people are real sick. They're real sick, and it's hard to get them back. You know, I mean, and so you're going to grab for things. There's no question. Now, what color eye do we have here? This is a blue eye. Looks green, looks hazel. If you get back, sometimes you get back far, they'll call this a brown eye. But realistically, that looks like orange to me around the pupil. Orange is softer. If that was brown around her pupil, that would be chronic lymph. And chronic lymph is not good. I mean, you're talking about the door of breaking down tissue. You're talking hypoactive, whether it's a gland, an organ, the bowels. Yeah, people don't poop well. Glands don't produce hormones and steroids well. And then they want to give them to you. Well, go back and make the gland healthy again, or you're not going to be happy taking hormones and steroids, whether you're a female or not. Now, you see all these little black lines radiating out from the pupil? These are called radius solaris. They're rare a lot of times in the blue eye, but you see these radiating out. It comes right into the pupil. That means this is big-time genetics. This comes out of the embryonic trunk, and this is the stomach. And it is invading the bowel wall as well. So these weaknesses come from the stomach and go right on out into the colon and even in the small bowel here. The small bowels are on the inside of the pupil, and the colon wraps around on the outside across the top. As you see here, up in this here, this is pituitary, very common weakness with colon problems here, and you see that right here. I'm coming back here. Now, this is cerebellum again. This is ear, cerebellum, and this is going to be equilibrium coming, dizziness coming. There's a lot of nerve rings in this eye. So here's the setup already for MS. She's got adrenal gland weakness, she's got a lot of nerve myelin sheath weakness, and she's got cerebellum. All those three are the setup for MS. Now, when the cerebellum's backed up, that cerebellum is at the back of the skull. The whole brain is backed up, and you see how thick this is up here? Here we see a lot of the fibers. We see the green, which will really become blue once the orange is taken out of here and the yellow is taken out of here. This eye will turn blue. Now, with all this, you don't see that up here. You don't see it up here. Now, up here from 1 to 2, say, or I mean from, say, 10:30 or so till about 1:30, that's all brain. And you see how thick that lymph is up in the brain? Her sinuses isn't draining because that bowel, that high sulfur is holding her lymph system up in her brain. Well, in genetics, it's broken down the cerebellum a little bit. It's picked up the pituitary. In the genetic downline, these radius solaris go all the way up. And then you really pick up brain lesions on a scan. So real important for this person to go after this. Here's the kidney down here and the adrenal gland. Kidney's fairly predominant here. The kidney's inflamed itself. See that white wall around that kidney lesion? I submit there's probably a little knee and upper femur weakness here. We're going over here to the hip. This is the right hip. And then a lot of congestion in that ovary and in that pancreas. There's a little liver, gallbladder weakness genetically, and a lot of inflammation in there. Here's some bronchial trunks we got to clean up, and a lot of lymph in that right ear. With that said, we got a parathyroid weakness over here. We got some throat going on, but look at this big skin ring. She wanted some skin ring photos. We've got some here for class. This is a nice big skin ring right here.
Look how dark.
Yeah. And I just made, but you go right over to the thyroid, because generally when you see a skin ring, your thyroid's down, you can't sweat, and it's a genetic capacity. It starts weakening the skin because acids build up subcutaneously, and then the skin starts going down. Then you start to see eczema, psoriasis, or some exotic Brazilian type. That's what some dermatologist told one of my clients who was just detoxing, and crap opened up and crap coming out of her head. Oh, I've never seen this. You have some rare Brazilian pathogen, and bop, 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 bop.
Blame it on that.
Oh my God.
Right. Terrible.
Beautiful eyelashes, I have to say, dear. There's that skin ring again. This is the left eye here. See the left eye part? Look at that kidney on the left eye. That's not a real happy kidney. Matter of fact, there's some deterioration in that kidney. Then there is a rectal wall weakness. There's a vaginal wall weakness. That's why I made that Hillol tea for the ladies to douche with. Start cleaning that vaginal wall, strengthening that vaginal wall at the same time. Open up this kidney filtration. Get this lymph moving through that kidney. Real important, but you see how she's starting to spoke out with these radius solaris?
They're dark.
They're dark. She's got to get in and fix her GI tract. That's real, real important to fix up that GI tract. Here's parathyroid big time right here. But all this thick yellow stuff here you see, guys, that's heavy lymph. The orange, of course, is sulfur, sucked into that lymph and just sitting there probably all her life. Okay. And when you see these, this is a 19-year-old female, toxic skin problems. Look at that. I probably should read these things when we're showing pictures, but it's just time. We just have a limited amount of time, and I apologize to you all dearly. With the photo, you did good with the photo, dear one. This is Rena, so you did good, sweetheart. I was born with hazel eyes, and it seems like it's brown around the pupil rather than orange. Well, if it is, sweetheart, that's chronic bowels. If that's not orange and that's brown, it's chronic bowels. And that just the same thing, whether it's orange or chronic bowels, that's where most of your karma is here in this lifetime in the body is the GI tract. And then the skin, that's your third kidney, and that's why you're holding. Everything's holding in there. That's why this is getting real thick here. Well, this is thick acids, and it's just going to sit there and chew on you. And that's, and here's a little, see, this is the left eye up here. So we're right here in the bronchial trunk or lung, and you're starting to get a lymph node swelling right here there. You don't want that to be in the lung and get a mass. So you just got to move that lymph, and you got to fix this kidney. So, sweetheart, carry on, my dear. That's a good skin one. Let's see, now look at this one. All right, so let's do the right one here. Sorry, these are small pictures, but I think we can get them with this camera pretty
beautiful
good.
Beautiful eyelashes. Look at that.
Oh, yeah. You know? Yeah. I was wondering if you could please do a reading. I have a 26-year-old male from Australia. I have recently been to see my MD, who advises me that I have high blood pressure at 151 over 91. Well, 91, that's your diastolic. That comes from these kidneys right here. Now, I don't see a lot of weaknesses. A little small for me to see here. but there's some kidney weakness there and a lot of lymph. So there's a lot of inflammation, can I use that word now, in your kidney. At the same time, this cerebellum's got to back up too. You want to make sure that this is, Ben, that this is not a swinging blood pressure. If your blood pressure's up at 91 one minute and low the next, you're going to come up here and clean these sinuses up. But to clean these sinuses up, you got to clean this up around the pupil. And what's around the pupil? The stomach and bowel area. And your stomach and bowel area, you've got prolapses. And this is common in the young people. It's common in all of us. You know, but worse in these young people is the condition of the colon. And you can see that even the small bowel here is prolapsed in places. So really another GI tract, but look at this skin ring. Look at this skin ring. So yeah, you're holding like the lady before you, my Ben, you're holding everything in there. See all this lymph, sinuses, there's some orange indication there, sulfur. Oh, you see those little white dots here? Those are lymph nodes. You have what we call a lymphatic rosary in iridology, meaning that most of your lymph nodes are swollen, and it makes a rosary around the eye. And just you're holding everything in. And you notice how the lymph nodes are close to the subcutaneous tissue, meaning right with the lower skin tissues? Absolutely. Again, here's thyroid up here, a lot of lymph, parathyroid, a lot of lymph in upper neck and back here. And you'd probably benefit from that kinesiology we were just showing you. Here's lower back, my friend. And mostly, you got a good body here. You just got this bowels. I don't like these bowels. This lymph is backed up. You got to open up this skin. Go to the thyroid gland to do that. Hungry, are we? She wanted some skin photos. She's got them. Look at all these skin photos today. Again, here is the skin notes? Ring. You got a real big skin ring, Ben. You got to get that's. You know, and then here's the kidney on the left side. Now, this adrenal gland looks like one big wad of mucus. Now, that's important that you get your kidneys filtering or you'll get cysts growing on or a tumor growing on that adrenal gland. And there you go, your lymph nodes are swollen all over the place. So you got some work to do, my friend. Here's upper neck here, a lot of lymph in the upper neck and area here. Here's the some throat area, voice box, more throat. You're going to have some sore throats during detoxing. Here's lower back. Here's the kidneys, really got to work on those kidneys. Here's the rectal wall there. Here is the male area here. Here's the bladder. So you just really got to get in and shake up this lymph system. Get to your kidneys, get to your skin, do skin, dry skin brushing, hot and cold showers, hydrotherapy, you know, get out in the sun, get yourself sweating, whatever you need to do. Because you're going to need to do that. Your skin is really backed up.
Natural vitamin D.
Natural vitamin D. Well, there's a process of how the body takes in and creates vitamin D. And so when you just take it, you get outside of that process. And that's the problem with taking things. The body has a natural rhythm of how it creates things. Just like vitamins. Mm-hmm. What do we need to create vitamins in our body? Bacterium, thank you. All right, so here's a 5'4". Let me see. Shipment for herbs, 110 pounds. I'm worried about losing too much weight. Here's another one that's skinny and worried about losing too much weight. I have a healthy metabolism and fairly athletic. I know it's fine to be lose some weight. Well, the loss of weight, let's see, who is this? A-L-I-N-A. Alana? That sweetheart, that's just... if you're malabsorbed, you're going to lose a lot of weight, and you can't help it. You got to fix that malabsorption. Well, let's look at Alana's eyes here. Again, we have the squiggly line pointing to her tonsils, but here we got another little bitty one kind of going to this mid-back area and lower back area. That's a big lower back weakness, but look at Lana's kidneys. Big-time kidneys here. She had nice lashes, too. Look at that kidney. Is that me? Well, I'm on a fast, man. Watermelon fast. You see that kidney and adrenal? That's in your face. And this is bladder, and that's worse than the kidney, sweetheart. You got to take care of your bladder. Now, the vaginal wall might be in there somewhere. I would douche anyway with the Hillol tea, work on my bladder, work on my kidneys. Here's the leg here, a lot of lymph, a lot of inflammation in the leg, here in the lower leg and ankle. Mm-hmm. Here's the groin, appendix is not real happy, and we're moving into the hip, and now we're moving into the ovary. So you just want to really just clean that lymph system out. Going backwards up here, this is the arm. Now, look, this is the right breast. I do not like that one little bit. You want to get in there and get this lymph and get this kidney fixed and get an adrenal and get this lymph moving, because that, see how dark that spot is? That is in your right breast. We don't like that. This is all lymph here, lungs good. Here's a spot up in the brain. Just need to clean this. Sinuses are thick up here. See this thickness? But see how her bowel's kind of ballooning out here a little bit and then prolapses down here a little bit. And here's a flexure supposed to be here. And then she's got some Humpty Dumpties here. So I want to come over here and look at the parathyroid. What we have here, just tons of lymph in that parathyroid. Little throat weakness here, upper neck.
Cause pituitary.
Tad bit of a skid, yeah. Well, you look at this, and I think this here, Drew, is not quite at the pituitary, but I think this is the pineal gland. Mm-hmm. So she's going to have some sleeping problems, maybe. Now, you see how this bowel's ballooned way out here? See how this goes way out here? That's a ballooning of the descending colon. This is just under the left breast area. And you get to the left breast area, and your whole chest wall's got some weaknesses on it here bilaterally. So this person could have fibrocystic breasts, that sort of thing. Now, this is at 3 o'clock, so this is a genetic heart weakness, guys. That's a perfect genetic heart weakness. Dr. Jensen did over 50,000 heart slides looking at these, and he related them to cerebellum, and here we have the cerebellum and the left shoulder. And this is what Jensen found in 90% of the cases. When you have a genetic heart weakness, you also have a cerebellum weakness and a left shoulder weakness, and here this person exudes what Jensen teaches. And I find that true, not in every case, but I do find it true in the majority of the cases, as he said. So there's that genetic heart. And see that lymph around that heart? You really want to move your lymph and then take a heart formula to strengthen the heart. Here's the skin ring that's obvious here. You want to get into your bowels here. You've got to really clean that up. Your stomach is almost, was over acidic and maybe going the other way now. You know, over acidosis then creates the decay, the innervation. This is just up in the head area. Like I said, drain those sinuses and get that lymph moving, and all this can repair. We got left ear involvement. We got cerebellum involvement. We have bronchial trunk. We have shoulder involvement here a little bit. This is a big-time kidney weakness, sweetheart. You got to get that out of there. That's not a happy kidney whatsoever. There's a knee going on here, a little bit of a groin going on here. Here's rectal wall going on here, and tons of lymph. You have to be careful. Colorectal cancer is a setup like this. So get this cleaned out of there. Vaginally, you might be okay. That's just a lot of lymph. So atypical cells would pop right and left here. This is the bladder and lower back here. See, there's a lot crammed in there, Drew, right in this area. Right between 6 o'clock and 7 o'clock, as you see on the chart, you've got the part of the leg, you got the kidney bladder, you got the scrotum, you got the rectum, you've got the vaginal or male. And that's just when time you hit 7 o'clock. So there's a lot crammed in this little space here when you're looking at that. Absolutely. So tear after that, dear one. You really need that. Do you recommend enemas? Yeah, use your herbs and your diet to deal with that. A lot of sites suggest colonics. Do a few, but you know what? That's not going to resurrect the bowels. It's just using your fresh fruits, berries, and melons, and using herbs are the best way to clean and restore the GI tract. My opinion, a lot of people play with colonics all the time and stuff, but you can innervate yourself real bad. Any suggestions on working through cravings? Yeah, parasite M, you know, because you get a lot of fungus involved in your eyes, sweetheart, in the body, and then you start craving it. Okay.
She'll get it. She's doing good.
Yeah. Yep. Now, here's some actual brown eyes. We don't get a lot of brown eyes here, an actual brown eye. There's a lot of light in here, which lights this up, so it looks so bright. But notice in a brown eye, where you can see the, on her case, where you see this thick white lymph, it's obvious in a blue eye. And the yellow is obvious in a blue eye. Brown is obvious in a blue eye. However, when you get to a brown eye, you have shades of brown. See all that light brown there? And this is a good example of nerve rings. See those nerve rings? Good example of nerve rings. But that light brown, and generally under a nerve ring, you'll see the actual color of your fiber, because that nerve ring cuts right down to the fiber. And you see this is a light brown eye. All this darker brown is their lymphatic problems. See how thicker this brown is above the pupil?
Yes.
Man, that's heavy lymph in the brain. Well, what is heavy lymph mean when it backs up? heavy acidosis, right? And what's the body's mechanism to fight acidosis? Adrenal steroids. But what's adrenal steroids made out of? Cholesterol. And so when the adrenals are down, then the lymph is down, then the body has to go to cholesterol, LDL specifically. And what do you see here? See that light kind of translucent ring here? That is a cholesterol ring. Yeah. Not good. That's a stroke heart attack coming. And look at the cataract. See that thickness? Even though this is a bright light, it's reflecting off of this. See that thickness in this eye? That is a cataract. And that's all cholesterol. Same stuff. And generally, now sometimes I had a lady who had a cataract the other day, didn't have any plaquing in, it didn't have a plaqued ring yet, but she's moving there, and what you see is heavy cataracts with the cholesterol ring. Going back, what are you going to find? Kidneys? What do we find? Kidneys. See that dark ring right there? That whole line there is the kidney and adrenals, and that's pretty dark. We start to get to bladder over here too. And then we have lower back, we have mid back, we have throat or upper neck. We have more throat, and we have a big parathyroid weakness right there. See that dark line coming out? That's at 230. That's parathyroid. Good genes for the most part, but these are some weaknesses they have to work through. This is the groin on the right side there, and the appendix is not real happy here. And here's the hip, chronic hip. And then we have a little pancreas right here, and maybe even a gallbladder. We need to clean all this out. You got to clean your bowels up. See how we keep going back to those bowels there and cleaning them up. A lot of lymph in the ear up here, shoulder. Now this is the left eye, a little better color. That other one had way too much light. Now you see here, see this cholesterol ring? It's not real heavy yet, but it's there. Meaning you got to back down. See all these blood vessels here? This is all inflammation. And you know, I don't like any of this. Clean the liver and everything out here. Now, a little bit of a cataract on this side. See all these radius solaris radiating out? Now, this is in this person's brain. This is the left side of the brain. This is the cerebellum. This is a perfect setup for MS, this case too. You've got the cerebellum, you've got the nerve rings and the chronic adrenals. Look at that kidney and adrenal on the left side. Upper femur on the left side, a little groin on the left side, probably invading the hip a little bit, a little testicle or ovary. The eyelash is probably a male here. Real dark around the bowel, so you have to clean all that up there. But pretty good genes, a little skin going on, of course, but you got to get into that lymph system and get up in that head and get it draining. Well, the only way to get the head draining is clean up the bowels and get the kidneys filtering. And then the head can clean up. And that's real important for this case because of that cholesterol ring. And this is, this is a female. This is Carla. And you got to be careful here with this cholesterol plaque, sweetheart. You got to get aggressive on the bowels there. Get the GI broom, the stomach and bowel, whatever, lymphatic one capsules, and go after that bowel. Go after your kidney and adrenals. If you don't do anything else, go after the bowels and the kidney and adrenals. That is going to be essential stuff because that's all lymphatic in origin, and you want to get up in that head and correct all these this area here. She's 61 years old, 5'1". So are we talking pituitary up here? Absolutely. 5'1", generally pituitary. You can correlate that with their menses and see how they were. If your menses is irregular, you know immediately. If they're too short, they've got menses problems, pituitary. Not that 5'1 is short. My sister's only 5'1". Look at that, and it doesn't have to be a lot, but a little bit of pituitary. We got to learn about all that the pituitary does for you.
What about endocrine glands? Endocrine.
Well, that's one of the formulas I'd be sucking down. You know, the endocrine gland formula. I mean, that's a real good formula. I've had so many good results from that one formula, and that's an herbal formula.
Because that does support the adrenals.
Yeah, if you're a female, you could use Chase Tree, which is for the female reproductive formula. That is a progesterone formula, but it has pituitary stuff in there, or you get a pituitary glandular. She has had ankle pain for months, no kidding. Look at that leg there. This is the right leg. There's the kidney right there and adrenals. This is the whole left leg. And you just, not only do you have weakness, you have a lot of lymph going on, a lot of acids going on. She did not injure her ankles. Of course she didn't. That's all lymph, sweetheart. Heartburn, everything else. She has a lot of redness and film over her left eye. No kidding. The doctor said it was due to the sun and told her to wear sunglasses.
Here we go.
Oh.
Again.
I'm telling you. I mean, I just thank God I'm not one of those guys that made that statement. I mean, Jesus friggin' criminy. But I will say this, guys, about sunglasses. Do not overwear them. You know, there's a reason why we have to give prisoners 1 hour of sun every day, and it's because you'll go blind if you don't. And in Florida, all these old people wear these sunglasses that wrap all the way around the head. Stupid.
24/7.
And they keep 24/7. They keep getting more blind, more blind, more blind. You need that full spectrum lighting to get into these rods and cones. And this optic nerve to feed the whole body. You know, part of the food on this planet is the sun. That's part of the food chain. Mm-hmm. And you've got to realize that. And you've got to use that sun as food. Even though you can argue about the different layers and being thinner and all this with the radiation, get to the sun. And that's what she needs to do. There's also an indentation in her left iris. This is right here, obviously. You know, I don't know. You know, it can be a genetic pass with that. Who knows? You know? But you would start to, when you start to see things like this, you would probably suggest parathyroid. It's hard to see right here, but my guess is she's probably dealing with some parathyroid. Her pituitary's down, so it could even bring the parathyroid. Even if you didn't have a lesion or a pattern in the parathyroid, that pituitary can shut that down. And that affects structure and the form of structure. So this could be an injury from way back in genetics and she's coming through that way. Or she's losing connective tissue. I don't see anything else here, a tumor or anything else to indicate that. She is taking glucosamine. Now, glucosamine what? Sulfate. She's on glucosamine sulfate, 1,500 milligrams with chondroitin, which has been suggested explode prostate and breast cancer.
Oh.
Chondroitin, bad, bad, bad. Mm-hmm. She's going the wrong way here. She's going to supplement calcium. She can stone herself up like a rock with a parathyroid weakness. She's on sulfur, more sulfur to hide the symptom. Sweetie, get off of those. Go right down and start moving your lymph. Fix your kidneys. Get your lymphs moving up through that leg so all this acids can come out of these ankles or you're going to lose your ankle. That's just what acids do. They chew. They're corrosive. And if you don't get that lymph filtering through the kidney, you're going to lose your whole leg. Look, your whole leg's involved left side. Upper femur more than anything. And then if we go back to your right side, we have, well, this is not the leg. Looks pretty clean here. This is the groin, I'm going to suspect. So it's the left side that you're really having trouble with. If you're swollen down there and pain on the right, it's just acidosis. And you really got to get off of this kind of crap you're on because you're going to hurt yourself. You're going to make your body full of fungus. You're going to have a lot of sulfur. And then it just goes on. And they suppress the lymph system. Calcium by itself can create stones. You got to be careful.
Look at the milligram.
Look at the what?
How many milligrams are per?
Oh, yeah. She's taking high dosages.
Man.
She's trying to treat a symptom that she has to change her viewpoint and go after the cause of it.
Look at that blue eye.
Yeah, and I mean, what do we see automatically? We see a major skin ring. Boy, today's the day for skin rings. She won't have to worry about finding eyes with skin rings. Look at these skin rings. That's huge. And you notice right under a skin ring, you have this thickened area. That thickened area is the subcutaneous tissues that also correspond to the friggin' lymph nodes. So this is part of the problem. Real dark around the stomach area. I don't like this stomach area on this eye. Very small pupil stress in the body. You see these scleric capillaries exposed like this. Looking at the right eye here, coming over here, wow, we got a right hip that's not real happy at all. I mean, it appears to be. I'm not going to map all these out. That would take forever. So I'm pretty sure I'm right at the hip, groin area here. And that's a real big right hip weakness. This moves around to the ovary or testicle. This is kidneys, not so bad, but a lot of lymph going on here. A lot of lymph in the lower back here. Hard to see with this eye, a lot of things. Little pituitary, it looks like here. This is going up toward the right ear. But you see how that bowel is ballooned out there and then getting right down to the pupil here. So you got a huge ballooned flex here, flexure. And then you've got a little spasticity maybe or some prolapsing here of the bowel. This is getting in the upper rib cage here, breast area, chest area here. Maybe we can see better in this other eye. A little better. But again, more skin rings here. All these lymph nodes are swollen all over the place. Again, work on the GI tract. See how we got some Humpty Dumpty, some bowel pocketed. So these could be called diverticulums. So that's a real suggestive of parathyroid. So we're going to come over here and look for parathyroid. Hard to see here. Don't see too much going on. A lot of lymph in the thyroid. Probably have a nodule. If not, you're going to have one. Pituitary, a little bit up here. A lot of lymph in the pituitary. This is lower back. Goes with the kidney right here. Here's kidneys. Here's rectal. Vaginal or male, a little bladder, a little lower back, a little groin, a little hip, and again, a little ovary or testicle on that side. Up here, another area. Now, this doesn't seem to go into the bowel ring so much, so I'm not going to say it's a heart, but it could be a little bit genetic heart weakness here, or it could just be the bronchial trunk there. So it's right at the 3 o'clock position, which is right at the heart lesion, does kind of tap that. So that could be another genetic heart we're looking at. And all you do is strengthen. Genetics simply means it can be strong or weak. Either one. It just simply means that cells are replicating themselves from memories. And you see this here. And of course, we're going moving toward the shoulder here and the cerebellum. So those are the three things that Jensen said you typically can see. So we do see that. We see this area, which is suggestive of heart. We see this area, suggestive of not only upper lung, but the shoulder, the left shoulder. And then we have that cerebellum, the equilibrium center, the parasympathetic center. And you have all those things there. So I think we can safely say that. And even if it wasn't, that what does it hurt to strengthen the body? Nothing. Thank you. That's why when we're wrong, no big deal. When they're wrong, serious consequences. And thank you. Who is this? Oh, this is Brittany. Hi, sweetheart. Honey, get after that body of yours. Get your skin refurbished. Get your lymph moving, sweetheart. And I think you're going to have a good, strong constitution here. Even though, you know, I'm pointing on your guys' weaknesses. Don't go freaking out now. All these are fixable, and your fibers are fairly nice and straight. So you'll be okay there, dear. She has been on antibiotics for acne for about 12 years. And you see why she has acne? Look at that skin. That's real weak skin. And that acne is coming from that thick subcutaneous congestion or constipation right there. And that's feeding out the skin, which is very weak. So you have weak cells and a backed up lymph system, sweetheart. And until you fix that, you're going to be fighting. The skin is just telling you what's going on inside of you. That's all it is. It says, hey, look what's going on in here. Well, you know, we're so used to treating these things and thinking there's some kind of diseases that's come into your life and all this crap that people just get confused. You just got to go in and fix this up. Use your dry skin brushing, as we've said, hot and cold showers. Get the thyroid up a little bit. Get your skin. Check your basal temperatures under your arms. Make sure they're up in the basal temperature proper areas, which is 97.8. Hopefully, at least 97.6, up to 98.2. She has scoliosis confirmed in third grade. Oh, my God. Mono in high school, menstrual issues, so we're at the pituitary. So that is a big pituitary issue. So go on the female reproductive or get into the pituitary gland, fix it up there. Scoliosis, that's parathyroid. That's what you see right here. Honey, you got to get into your, that's parathyroid and thyroid. Get into your thyroid, parathyroid, get that lymph moving, and your back will straighten right back up. You got a lot of lymph in the back, could be pulling on one side or the other. Yeah, now look at this. This is, you see where she's weak here in the back here? She has mid-back weaknesses to the lower back. So she, and upper neck, this whole back is weak left side. See that? And all this lymph is acidosis, and it can stiffen that back up, and it can pull from one side to another. That's why you always have to fix the kidneys to fix the back. You have to get the adrenals up to fix the back. You've got to get the lymph moving to fix the back, and the back will pull itself straight. And that's why we put that quad up there to show you extreme scoliosis, what can happen. Pulled itself straight. So, sweetheart, now she's got melanoma. That's obvious. I mean, look at that skin weakness. That's lymphatic, honey. She didn't help. I used to love the tanning bed. Oh, my God. Yeah, that didn't help, sweetheart. And that's another thing. Yeah. People don't look at, you know, these people that own these tanning beds, they don't look at your skin or look at your eye and say, oh no, you got a weak skin, this is going to burn your skin more, it's going to break down your skin more. They don't do that sort of thing.
She's got bad cramps, okay, so we're going back to a parathyroid again. Depression, parathyroid, panic attacks, adrenals, Raynaud's. Okay, go to the kidneys and adrenals. Fix those up. Get your thyroid fixed up. She can feel her lymph nodes in her throat. Going to be fun detoxing. Yeah, it is, sweetheart. But go for it, honey. What complicates the meningitis? She has a 10-month-old little baby. He is strong and healthy, baby. He's an Aries like me. All right.
Is he?
Yep. Wow. Coming to help us. But I do see in his lymph nodes, in his eyes. Oh, yeah, sweetheart. Well, you know what? You just do what we're talking about. With a little baby like that, give him a couple drops of kidney number one, a couple drops of lymphatic number one. And at 10 months, you better be on a lot of fruit. He predominantly, at 10 months, you should be on all fruit, berries and melons, and some coconut milk or water.
Nice. He has a fun journey ahead.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, his mama, you know, has got pretty good genes. If she gets this lymph moving, gets the skin focused, and gets the gut cleaned up, mm-hmm. she can clean that up. And the baby, as he grows, can clean himself up and be in good shape. Now, no offense, but this is what I call a dirty eye. There's a lot of light in there, which brings out, it's not a true color. See how there's way too much light in this eye. But it was a good chance. See these blood vessels again and how they come right in. Look at all this mess in here. See these dark areas here? That's all throat. That's all thyroid, parathyroid. Right there's a nice parathyroid genetics, big time, right there. See that? It's encased in there, Drew. Dark, see all this brown? This is blue eye. If you did not see this eye, you wouldn't know how to call this one. But when you look at the left eye, blue. This is a blue eye. See all the blue in this eye? This is a sore spot or a drug deposit here. That's going to be, probably over your testy, close to that area. But this thickness, this thick yellowish brown stuff, that's subacute to chronic. Yeah, right there is where it is, see?
Yeah.
So it's probably going to be part of that. Yeah, it can be abdominal cavity too. It can be in the abdominal cavity there. It doesn't show that, but that's where that could be there. You have to look at the other chart to see that. Yeah, because how do you show an abdomen there? Adrenals are chronic with this case. I don't like this kidney at all. The groin here is involved. This is lower back. The skin, see how this skin ring on this side? This is the day of the skin rings. And this has just locked all this lymph system in on this poor person. Real dark around the stomach area. And you need to get that out of there. Clean that stomach up a little bit here. Real thick here. Got a real big malabsorption ring. So this person's very malabsorbed. This is a chronic pituitary problem here. And so you got to get in here and clean some of this up. This is the left eye, so there's the throat or thyroid area. That's probably more thyroid. Real bucking real close to the thyroid or throat right there. But all this, you just got to get in your skin, get in your kidneys and adrenals, so you can get in here and clean some of this up. Clean the bowels, get the skin refurbished. Again, see how this blood vessel equates to this dark area right here, almost mm-hmm. straight there? Absolutely. Going back to the right eye, this is just thick lymph. Thick lymph. Subacute and chronic. Chronic is the brown, subacute is the yellowing. But you get to see the shape of the bowel. Now, some bowels come out real big like this. And someone used to say, well, the diameter of the bowel is bigger when they come out like this. I don't know. I have to see research on some things. Even though you guys don't think I'm a science-minded person, I'm extremely science-minded. Just because I cut the crap out of stuff and narrow it down so it's easy to understand doesn't mean I'm not a thinker. Just because I'm not the best English major doesn't mean I'm not a thinker.
You're a simplifier.
Yeah. I mean, that's the whole idea, simplification.
Yeah.
If not, you get trapped in the mind, you're gone. You're done. Now, look at this. This is skin here as well. A lot of work needs to go here. Kidney not so bad here, guy, on the right side, but that adrenal sitting there pretty chronic. There's a knee right there, a big right knee. I know that person feels that knee right there. Here's a groin right here. Look at this thick, thick, thick lymph right here. So you got a lot of lymph and going right back to the pituitary. You got to get up in your brain. I would do upper circ brain and nerve, really dig into that GI tract, get my adrenals up. Here's parathyroid, thyroid. You might go through that way. You're the glandulars for the pituitary and then shift to the thyroid, parathyroid and go back and forth. You might be getting a little cataract here, and that might be a little cholesterol haze there, even down here a little bit. Just that when you really bring the light in an eye, it really can show things that you can't see, generally speaking. This is more an appropriate color, although it's probably different still. Look at the skin tone here. But that's a blue eye. I'm sending good close-up pictures of my eyes if you have time. Thank you. Who is this? Doesn't say who this is, but much love to you, my friend.
No name?
That is a no name.
All right. That's okay.
We're getting down there, Drew. We only have a whole load more. Look.
A few.
Matter of fact, I'm going to turn them upside down because some of these could have been first. You know what I'm saying? They've been patiently waiting. And I apologize. It's just going to be like this because I'm still seeing people. So I apologize here how long it takes me to get to some of these things. But this is a free look at your eyes. So I don't know what to say. Blue eye, of course. Look at all the blood vessels. Yeah, that shows a lot of inflammation or acidosis. And this is up in the brain area. And this is going right to the cerebellum right here. See how these are coming, pointing mm-hmm. right at the cerebellum, and you see some things. This is dizziness, equilibrium, center of the body, of course, stability, that sort of thing, vertigo. You can get nauseated from this area, swinging blood pressure from this area. Look at how this bowel kind of goes humpty-dumpty here a little bit. So there's some minor prolapsing and ballooning of the bowel. This is a little thyroid here.
See a drug deposit.
There's a drug deposit, exactly, right there. And that's a bladder, it looks like to me. Now, and I got this measured off, so it's either lower back or that looks like an iodine deposit, a reddish, brownish look. That's in the bladder or coccyx of the person. Here's a little female or male here. Now, the adrenals aren't so bad, but a lot of lymph up there. The kidney doesn't look too bad, which is really great. So they should be able to open up this and drain this pretty easy. Here's a spot in the groin. It can yield you a hernia, so you have to be real careful here not to do too much and clean this. See how that thick lymph is? It's going to chew on these tissues and then herniate the tissue. Here's a little hip going on. I'll say just a little bit there. Then we get into a little pancreas. Little gallbladder needs to clean this out because you see that gallbladder is immersed in thick. See that little spot right there? That's a gallbladder hiding deep within a big wad of mucus. And then we start to see the liver a little bit here as well. Here we got a right breast weakness going on here, and we get into a lower lobe weakness in this lung pattern here, some bronchioles, some congestion in the upper lobe with some weaknesses, a little weakness in the right ear. This is a little dark for us to see, but these fibers are fairly nice and straight, dear one. So that means you have great genes. Look how little your pupil is, though. A lot of stress, a lot of inflammation, but look at your sclera. Look at all the red blood vessels here. And this squiggly one goes right up to your tonsil or thyroid, actually. And there's the thyroid weakness right there. Here's an upper neck weakness to the throat. Here's a little lower back down here. Of course, we're getting down. I don't know, Drew, can you see this here? Here's the kidney. Here is the left side is where your kidneys are weak. On this side and adrenals. Here's probably knee or groin here. Here's spleen right up here. So you want to clean your spleen out. Up here we've got the left ear. We've got the cerebellum, mastoid. And you see those are involved. With all this inflammation, you can get a little dizzy. Equilibrium center. There's a little bit of a skin ring. You're starting to get just a little hue here of violet. Now, it's not much, but that would be poor blood flow. And that is Baja. This is the second letter to you. I am so happy I found out about you. Sorry about that. Let's see. It is interesting how it works. You search and you shall find. Thanks, my friend. I have climbed greater muscular. Oh, so yeah, it's MD. Muscular dystrophy. Now, you've got a good eye, man. You've got a good eye to pull yourself out of MD here. you've got a good eye to do that. You get your thyroid up, you get up in the head with upper circ, brain, and nerves, start getting out that central nervous system in shape, clean your muscles, get all your lymphs moving out of your muscles, because it's breaking, I mean, you got a lot of inflammation, and that's what shows in this eye with this, is just a lot of inflammation. Well, acidosis breaks down muscle tissue, bone tissue, things like that. Well, then you have a nervous system in there. I don't see any real big nerve rings, and you got good genes, so you shouldn't have to put up with that too much longer. Take you about a year or two maybe to get out from that. If you do it 1 year real good, raw, you should be out of that MD. As you might guess, medical doctors said that there's no treatment. Well, of course not. That's why they get lots of money through Jerry Lewis. But with that said, I so enjoyed it for a while. I thought so too. But thanks for the internet, I was able to discover Dr. Christopher, Dr. Richard Schultz, hey Richard, Max Gearson, and others. I got myself a copy of Dr. Schultz's Save Your Life manual. Good, good. For the past 3 to 4 years, I played around with the protocols. I couldn't progress with my condition. Blame myself. I didn't follow the protocols completely. Well, you know what? Now, my friend, you got everything's working for you. Get that raw. Also, I'm very interested in OBE, out-of-body experiences. Absolutely. Well, I'm going to. You know what? Things are happening where I'm going to have more time with this. So hopefully we'll have some really good communication there. But you go after that MD. I want to show this young child with MD, and I just want to show you what has happened to a child we all thought was going to die.
You don't have the photos?
No, I don't have any photos. But we thought, I'm pretty good at telling you whether you're going to stay or go. And I'll tell you, this kid surprised me. I thought he was going to go. And just looking at him, I mean, it was amazing. And he made a 180. I mean, I can't believe it. And this child is, I mean, I'll show you this if the mother will let me show you these things. Now, we have two different eye photos, and to be honest with you, this is the right. Mm-hmm. And this is Jazz, all that Jazz. Thank you. This is a 26-year-old male, and I have been going through some strange health problems for the past 9 months. Now, someone 26 years old shouldn't have health problems. My experiences for the last 9 months will be really difficult to explain in an email. Medical advice has been useless, and doctors keep recommending antidepressants. Okay, so let's look at this, man. This is a brown eye. See how hard brown eyes are to read if you don't have a lot of light? So I use a side light here, which brings out these fibers more and gives me more of a 3D look. If you do straight on, like with a ring flash or a light straight away, you don't get that. You get more of a flat look to the eye, but if you come in here on an angle, you'll light that eye up on an angle, and it'll light up all these weaknesses here, and you'll be able to see them more. It's obvious that the darker brown is right around the pupil here. You see nerve rings right here. This person can get themselves pretty healthy as far as I'm concerned. You don't see a lot of lacunas or crypts here. You see mainly colon. Down here you see a little adrenals, kidneys, but this is real hard to read without more light on there. I'm afraid to tell you anything because it might be wrong. This looks like a pancreatic, a liver, gallbladder here. A lot of congestion in the sinuses. A tonsil not real happy. This is probably pituitary a little bit, but right here where your parathyroid is, my friend, you've got a pretty dark area. That would lead you into depression and unhappiness and a lack of self-worth. That's what all that would lead to. Then you got a little upper back going on here, mid back going on here. Let's see if we can see better with his other eye.
Yeah.
But you see, you have all these squiggly lines again, these capillaries here showing, pointing to the back here, pointing to the throat, pointing to the thyroid. Now, here's a big parathyroid weakness. So I submit to you, you work on your parathyroid gland, it'll pull you out of some of that. A lot of lymph going on in the pituitary here. A little bit of skin going on. Faint look of cataracts here. But this is a good eye to get healthy. Got the bladder and got the kidney here. Just a lot of lymph going on, rectal and lower back and stuff. But, you know, really, get after that GI tract. That's where you're real dark. Get after your adrenals. That's your nerve rings and your kidneys. And get that kidney, start cleaning that lymph system up. And you should be pretty good there. Yep. I'll pull you out of depression, kill the fungus in your body too. That'll help, or at least as much as you can get a hold of that. Okay. So a Sandor. Hey, Sandor. Hey, my friend. To a 6-year-old male from Hungary. He'll try to be short. Let me see. From age of 10. His body broke down of age of 10. Allergies. Okay, so let me go through these real quick. Allergies, lymphatic, asthma, adrenal, neurological, autonomic nervous system to the lungs, eczema, skin, lymphatics, acne, skin, lymphatics. On top of that, my parents unfortunately didn't know how much about any naturopathic alternatives, so I had to face many drugs as well. Inhalation drugs, allergy drugs, steroid-based creams. And the problem, again, with these steroid-based creams and inhalers and stuff is wrecking a person's adrenal gland. Well, first thing right off is a chronic adrenal gland. Look right there. See that dark area right here? Even the bowels ballooned right at the adrenal gland.
Yeah.
So that's your right adrenal gland. Your kidney not so bad, though, but it's still weak there. You got to clean all that out and get that adrenal up on light. There's your right knee and a lot of inflammation in that knee area. There's your groin there. And then here's a hip that's headed towards some problems here. A lot of inflammation in the right hip there, also in the testicle on that side. And then we work our way up to the liver, gallbladder, and the pancreas. So this is an area that needs to work on liver, gallbladder, pancreas, kidney, adrenals. Get this lymph pulled out of this leg so this knee can to fix itself up. Here's coccyx. A little male going on here. A lot of lymph in the prostate. Is this a male? Yeah. While we're here, we've got throat. You got upper neck there, a little throat. A little thyroid going on in here, man. Little dark up here for me to see, but that looks like pituitary and pineal gland both. Right there's the pineal gland, right there's the pituitary. That would yield you all kinds of problems, sleeping problems with the pineal and all kinds of endocrine gland problems because you have a little thyroid and a little pituitary. Here is bronchial trunk. It's got, see that yellowish look? That could be subacute or it could be hints of sulfur. Doesn't matter, it's all got to clean out. Now, you got a little thickness around to that bowel wall. Remember we talked about that this is a collaret. We call this a bowel collaret. You see the thickness of that collaret, that little thick rim there? That's malabsorption. That's lymph in the bowel wall hardening up over time. Acids harden, dehydrate, and harden things. This is the left eye. Now, right there is a little heart weakness right there, and a lot of lymph around it. So you want to clean that lymph system out and get that opened up. Maybe take a heart formula and strengthen up that heart. There's a lot of lymph down the spleen and in the body here. Here's the left adrenal gland encased in that heavy lymph up there, and then the kidneys down below. Here's another left knee problem. A little groin going on and working on a hip right up here. See that little weakness of the hip? And that's where this femur right here goes into the hip. Well, this is the adrenal gland, but right up in here. Then we have some rectal wall, little minor rectal wall, little bladder here. But as we're going into that coccyx and lower back, you got a little bit of lower back here. This is up in the forehead up here and the eyes itself. It's hard to see up here. There's so much
glare.
Yeah, glare. The glare. So a year ago, I started doing yoga meditations each day and intuitively stopped eating meat and started eating generally much less and light food. I started reading spiritual books. This guy is a good guy right here. Girls, this is a good man right here. 26-year-old spiritual man. Mainly on my face, rashes and stuff. So, you know, automatically when you see that on the third kidney of the skin, you know your lymph is backing up. And that's what you see here. The skin's not too weak, a little bit in places, no question, getting that. But then a kidney, get this filtering. This is a blue eye, of course, and all this white in this blue eye, all this yellow sulfur or yellow subacute, all that's got to come out. This is what all you blue eyes should look like. That's what all you blue eyes should look like. At least that's a good jump See all these nice fibers, nice and straight here. This person's got their little, we can get real picky and we can say that's a little weakness here, there's a little weakness there, the kidney's there, there's a little weakness, here's a little weakness. I can point to these weaknesses, but if you've got that eye, you're going way out. Because this is a healthy, healthy eye. I love that. So that's what this eye needs to look like. And it's white. If I put thick white in here, it'll start looking like this eye, just like this. Okay. Thank you, my friend, for submitting that. Let's see. Very dry skin. No kidding. Skin rashes and itching. So you see how all that's lymphatics. He looks like hell. But since I knew what was happening, I could feel good about it. Yeah. Right, let me see here. A question regarding mainly to the selection of herbs. I've made the basal temperature study for my thyroid function. It's constantly at 97.2, constantly too low. But I'll say that it's not that low. With a 97 or above, it's not so much chronic as 96s, and 95s are real chronic. So, pop yourself up with a glandular for the thyroid, or use the endocrine gland formula, thyroid formula herbal-wise, or hit that pituitary as well. I can't have too deep regenerating sleep because you have a parathyroid pineal gland weakness that shows up. You can use the pineal gland glandular, but drain those sinuses. Fix that bowel. Fix that bowel and drain those sinuses. And again, we're right back here to your pineal gland right there. And see that thick up here? It's hard to see, but there's thick up here. That's sinuses. That's a genetic past, by the way, my friend, pineal and pituitary. But it comes from people that let their sinuses go, get backed up, and their bowels, and don't know how to detox. You get a pretty good, nice bowel diameter, but it looks like you have some prolapsing up here, a little area here. But let's see what else here. My hair started thinning and falling out a couple of years ago. Lymph, sinuses, chemotherapy, acidosis, clean all that out. Might get your bowels cleaned up and drain your head out, and you'll get new hair coming up there like crazy. This is from L-E-I-L-A.
Layla.
You get that out of that?
Yeah, I got it.
She's 36 years old. She's talking about someone else here. That's her husband's eyes. I have submitted my husband's eyes, Lazarus. Oh, sorry, man. But this is her husband's eyes here. He's 36-year-old male. He did 120 days of a juice fast 3 years ago and mainly vegetarian. Family histories of diabetes. A stool looks like undigested food sometimes. Pancreas, right? Yep. Bad night coughing for about 2 months in springtime every year. Sometimes lower back problems. Thank you, sweetheart. Well, let's look here. Let's look at the hubby poo. Well, I like the bowel, the shape. See this differentiated area around the pupil? That's the GI tract. Stomach immediately around the pupil. And look at an iris chart. And then look at this ring. And we probably should show the iris chart.
Yeah, so we can compare. Okay,
so you can compare. Yeah. So just let's throw this up here for a minute so you guys can lock down on this. Now, this is a little ratty, but I've carried this around for at least 30 years. Okay. So you see this bowel ring immediately, and we're going back to this. Sorry, Drew. Immediately around the pupil here is the stomach. It makes a perfect circle. And you'll see it in your eyes when you have acidosis in the stomach. You see a perfect stomach ring. But outside of that stomach is the colon on the outside of the eyes and the small bowels on the inside, closest to the nose. And then from there, you have all these fibers emanating out of this differentiated area, which is the embryonic trunk. And then you have all the tissues coming out of there. And how the head sits right on top of this transverse bowel. That's why there's this link, always. And you see it in the eye every time between the transverse colon and the head area. And that's why these bowels are so important to clean up. So in looking at this, this is a pretty nice ring. Not a lot of prolapsus going on, so I'm real happy about that. I go over here to look for a parathyroid weakness. Might be a little bit, but it's not so bad. Here, a little indentation right here, so some minor prolapsing of the ascending colon, which is on the right side up. Now, here we go. Now, this looks like a knee right here. That dark spot right there, there's the kidney and adrenals. This is a male. This might be bladder. A lot of inflammation in the prostate. And look at all this lymph going up the back of this person. A lot of lymph going up the back. That's up reaching up here in the, there's the parathyroid reaching up in the throat. A lot of sinus, a few places in the head. This is the cerebellum, the equilibrium center. Coming down, there's a weakness in the right ear. A lot of inflammation in his shoulder. But he's got good, strong genes here. So this is a good eye to take care of. This is a groin here. This is a right hip. And now we get into the pancreas. And this is what you said, dear. See that little one right there? That's his pancreas and his right testicle. And that's a thick. Not only does he have the genetic lesion, that little line there, he's got that thick lymph, probably invading even the gallbladder here. So really want to move that lymph, go in a pancreatic formula there to help boost that pancreas up, but move thy lymphs. And here we're going back to the skin ring again. See the skin ring here? Oops.
Nice catch.
About that. Are we good? Do I need to move that?
Nope, just me.
Okay. Again, you see all these blood vessels, meaning his body's full of inflammation. Well, what's inflammation look like in the eye? All this white lymph, yellow lymph, brown lymph. Got a nerve ring here showing up. Not too many, so that's good. Hard to see right here. This is too far up to be the kidney and adrenals, so this is probably rectal wall. So that rectum is weak there, looks like to me. This is lower back, of course. A lot of lymph in the bladder, prostate. This is going up the back, though. So you got a little lower back going on again. Here's a lot of throat. Maybe invading the thyroid. A lot of mucus up there in that. This is the cerebellum up here. Equilibrium center and the left ear as well. So you were right, sweetheart. It's definitely his pancreas. It's another skin ring. Here, I'll give her a bunch of skin rings today. Oh. Where's our time? You haven't even gone to lunch yet.
You poor thing.
Yeah. I tell you what, we'll cut off now because we've shown a lot of... This one is too dark.
Get to this one real quick.
Yeah.
Like that one.
Okay, now...
It's 4:30.
It's 4:30. Yeah,
okay.
It's 4:30 somewhere.
Yeah.
See how dark this sweetheart. This eye is way too dark for me to see. As a 39-year-old female, and the quality isn't good enough, sweetheart. Sorry about that. Frequently, because there's frequent migraines. All right, so fix up this stomach. Get this head drained. It's way too dark, but you can see a lot of lymphatic stagnation. I can see your kidney right here. Oh, yeah, okay, all right, a good idea, thank you. Mm-hmm. Well, in the right kidney right here, that's thick lymph in that right kidney. Yeah, see, oh, Drew, I love that. Yeah, here's a leg right down here. Here's a hip right here with thick mucus in here. Yeah, and as we go up here, that's more pancreatic right here and ovary. This is the right breast area. Yeah, then we get up into the lung pattern, we get up into the ear, this is the right ear, and then we get up into the cerebellum here. Right there is pituitary. Yeah, a little bit of a skin ring here. Yeah, what are we doing over there? Yeah, now look at the back over here. See the back? This is the upper back, lower back here. Yeah, good. Lower back here. Yeah. And then we have a lot of lymph in the bladder going on, vaginal wall here, uterus. You need to clean all this out. See how thick that white spot is right there? That's your kidney. And you're going to see that's where a kidney can start breaking down on you because it's so white there, thick. A lot of lymph, a lot of acidosis. Oh, Drew, that worked out pretty good. Let's look at our left eye. That worked out real good.
Yeah, if you can't read an eye, sometimes it shows up better.
Oh, man, it shows up lots better. What else does she say here? Throat pain, lots of antibiotics. Throat pain. What's pain? Where does pain come from? All right, just stop and think. How many sides of chemistry? We're in a chemical universe. Acids. And so what system deals with acids? The lymphatic system. And you see that. Let's look at her throat right there. Well, throat's right here. There's a little weakness. But see that lymph? See that thick lymph in your throat, sweetheart? See that thick white stuff in your throat? That's lymph. So that's going to set up inflammation and a sore throat. You might even detox. You might even lose your voice, but it's going to get sore for the last time and spit all that mucus out. With that said, look at this kidney on this left side here, this leg, this groin, this kidney here, real dark right here. Here is the bladder and lower back area, really dark up. Again, yeah, throat area right there. See all that? Good, Drew. Good, good, good. See that right there? She's got a weakness and she's got a big wad of mucus in that throat. Up here though, she's got, yeah, up here she's got shoulder, she's got ear, and it's spilling over into her mastoid and cerebellum here. Now look over here, right there is pituitary. See that? That's pituitary. We're looking on the camera because your eyes are too dark for me to look at there. So if I'm looking at the wiggle, and this is because I'm looking in the camera at the eye, real chronic pituitary right there. See how that dark line goes straight up in the brain? You want to get up here with upper circuit brain and nerve. Get that lymph moving. Yeah, see that? That's good, Drew. See over here at the cerebellum? And if I'm not mistaken, there's nerve rings in this eye, a little bit anyway. So you see all these lymph nodes right around here. Mm-hmm. So let's look through this. I looked under nourish, too thin, fix up the bowels, get your digestion going up, sweetheart. Big black circles under the eyes, that's your kidneys. Cold hands and feet, that's your thyroid gland. Reoccurring hemorrhoids, work on your parathyroid. You got to work on your pituitary, actually, and that'll resonate back to the thyroid and parathyroid. Went away raw food diet and fruit, but in 2007 I had anal abscesses. That's what I mean. Move your lymph, because that's in that lower rectal area here. And you have a real weakness in that rectal area as well. And then all this lymph build up here. But this is a weakness as well in this rectal wall. And you don't want to go into colorectal cancer. So you want to really dig in and get this lymph moving. That's what an anal abscess, fistulas, and things like that are. Both needed a small surgery. Oh, wow. All right, sweetheart. I'm a fan of yours too, honey. So you just get in there and get your health back. There's another one. I tell you what, let's finish these up in another day, because you haven't even had lunch yet. It's 2 o'clock. We've got about 4 or 5 more eyes to do.
This is right after, like maybe about an hour.
Okay, all right, I can come back. Yeah, we only have a few more eyes to do. I would love to finish this up, but
finish it up right now.
You want to do it?
Yeah.
Okay. Absolutely. So, all right. So let's go a little faster. Oh, I've got 2 eyes here. I've got K-I-N-A.
Kina.
Kina. All right, Kina, what we have here, dear one, is a blue eye with heavy skin problems. See that skin ring? Look at the sulfur around the pupil. All this in here is thick lymph. Your lymph nodes are swollen, sweetheart. Got some iodine deposits right there. So right eye, what we've got is a lot of throat congestion and weaknesses going on with some upper neck. We got some mid to lower back, a lot of inflammation lower back, and a little lower back weakness related to this kidney and adrenal. There's your adrenal gland right there, not real happy. A little upper femur weakness, a little groin. This could be invading the right hip area. A little dark on you, I don't like that. So again, you've got to get that lymph filtering through that kidney, get your parathyroid, and right here we see a possible parathyroid to a throat weakness right here. All this thick, thick, white, yellowy stuff, lymph, 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 lymph. Clean that out. This drug deposit's in your mid-lobe of your right lung, by the way. This is bronchial trunks, filling into, affecting, moving up into the right ear area, a little medulla weakness right there, and a cerebellum going on. Want to get these areas out of the brain here, forehead out of here. Start draining your lymph. Get this sulfur out of your bowels. Big time skin ring, sweetheart. Nice eyelashes.
I see nodes and nerve rings.
Yep, and guess what color eye you have?
Perfect.
Hard to imagine, isn't it, that you see an eye like that? All right, so you got a skin. You're holding everything in. See how thick you are here, sweetheart? You're holding everything in. Got a thick bowel collarette here. Gives you a little malabsorption going on here. This is up near the left shoulder and left ear. Thick up here. A couple spots in the brain here. You want to get this out of here. Here's more kidney and adrenals, of course. Here's a little female. Here's a little bladder. And then a lot of inflammation, lower back, a little weakness. But your upper neck here, thick, thick, thick with lymph. Do that kinesiology we showed you earlier and help move that out and get your lymph moving. This is real thick, all this thick. Good genes, though. I'll say that. Pretty good genes she's got. Now, there's some other eye pictures with this. This is Sonix.
Yes.
Sonix?
Yep.
So let's look at the right eye here. I want some nice eyelashes. Again, look at this. Look at the nerve rings. Look at all the nerve rings. So you immediately know to go to the adrenals, which is trapped in that chronic lymph, that brown chronic lymph. This is a chronic GI tract here. See how dark this is? Very chronic here. Here's a little kidney right here going on here. Here's a groin going on here. Or that's actually almost to the left or the right hip. And then we have pancreas, little gallbladder. This is also going to affect the right ovary. This is near the right breast area, so there's a weakness, a possibility of having a lot of lymph buildup. We want to clean all this out. Get this bowel. Everything hits into the colon, so clean this colon up. We're a chronic colon here. Skin, look at that skin ring. Look at that eye. Look at all those blood vessels. Heavy lymphatic problems, and that's heavy acidosis.
Look at the nerve rings.
Yeah, yeah, that's very, you know, you got a lot of nerve rings here. So this is a person that's way down the genetic line of the adrenals, and here is chronic adrenals right here. See how these dark radius solaris radiate out of the bowel, and this is radiating up her back, left side, back, a lower back, mid back. Pretty good genes, but look at this up here.
Heavy lines.
Cerebellum, yeah. Yeah. Cerebellum, medulla, up in the left hemisphere up here. Kidneys. But, you know, not bad. Just got to get in there. Get these kidneys and adrenals, clean up the bowels, and you can see why we're after those same tissues every time with everybody. Because they connect and control mm-hmm. this gigantic sewer system, which you're beginning to see that most people are involved in. I don't have time to read this one, guys. I'm sorry. Yeah, resubmit a question if you want, please, because I just don't have the time to do that right now. I want to get these eye pictures through here. They've been sitting here a long time. Let me see how this is.
It looks like a globe.
Yeah, it does look like a globe. This is left.
Looks like Earth.
Yeah, Earth. All right, here's planet Earth. And this is W-I-K-T-O-R.
Victor.
Now, here's a blue eye, obviously, but here's where you see brown in a blue eye. Here is chronic lymph. See that brown, thick brown? But what's all this blue underneath here? That's the actual fiber. That's the actual color of this person's eye is blue. All this chronic brown is chronic lymphatics. All these dark lines here like this, these are all lacunas, radius solarises, on and on and on. Deeper ones are called crypts, fiber patterns, whatever you want to call them. Big time. Here's kidney here. Here's leg here. This looks like the pancreatic area. This little spot up here is going to be the right hip. Right here is real dark pancreatic area, my friend. You got to work on your pancreas, clean your gallbladder out. This could be your arm here, up in your shoulder toward your upper arm, above the elbow. Chest area here. Look at how thick this is up here, though. When you leave this perimeter, this lower portion, it gets real dark. And this is your sinuses and your brain. See that black spot going up in the brain? You got to get this out of here. Get this spot out of here. Here's your pituitary. So look at all these spots up into the cerebellum. Here's equilibrium, dizzy center, flipping blood pressures, the ear here, the shoulder here. All this is involved on the right side. So you've got to really dig into that bowel and get these kidneys and adrenals up and start cleaning this out. You got some nerve rings here, obviously, and that goes back to the adrenal glands. So you really want to honk on that, clean all this brown, and get your blue eye back. Same type of thing. Now notice this is all in your cerebellum. I don't know if you have MS or what. I just don't have enough time to read all these and get this done. So I apologize. Please resubmit your questions. Adrenal sphere, shyness, absolutely. I'm sorry, I just don't have time to read all your comments. This is a 27-year-old, 6'1", skinny, trouble gaining weight and some muscle, but look at the lymphs around the bowel area here. Cold hands and feet, thyroid, my teeth are in terrible shape, almost every tooth has a decay. That's your lymph system. Lymph, lymph, lymph. I was force-fed sometimes with cooked meat and potatoes. No, force-fed. Look at that. Oh my God, but they have longevity. And I have to say that you got good, nice genes here. Look at these fibers. These are not good. Get them out of here. These are radius solar. See how black that is, my friend? That's up in your cerebellum. If you haven't mentioned dizziness or equilibrium or, this is real serious here. This is a serious pituitary weakness going up. It's probably why you're 6'1". Oh, yeah. Yeah, you really see there. See that? You really see that up in there. See these dark lines? See, guys? These shouldn't be here. And they come right out of that bowel wall right there.
They branch out.
Yeah, they branch out. And you see, these are younger ones, and these are older ones. Meaning, these are deeper, more long-standing in your genetic history. These are newer ones developing in your genetic past. See how light they are? All these little lines get big like this, and that was what I was talking about. Whoops. That's what I was talking about earlier. Now, coming down here, that's your leg right there.
Look at those.
Yeah, and there's your kidneys. Holy crap, the groin right here. And then up here in the spleen as well. Yeah, a lot of lymph going on here. Look at the nerve rings. So, my friend, you got to get into your lymph. Upper circuit, brain, and nerve live on it. Look at all that up there. Get this out of here. Get this bowel. Now, you got a pretty good bowel diameter, but all this lymph and stuff, get that out of there. And you'll be in good shape there. Got good genes, your family lives long. Go into your adrenals, go into what you know to be true. And, we've only got two more. All right, I'm going to get killed. You just don't want to go out there and answer phones. I know you.
You hear my smile.
I know. All right, so I've discovered you all. Thank you so much. This is the same person, BAJA. So this is the second time we've looked at this eye.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. This is the second time we've looked at this eye. So what I'm going to do is put this on because I'm just out of time. I apologize so much. Now, here's the last one. This is hard to read. Another one that's hard to read for us.
You've already done that one.
Oh, I've already done it. All right, so I've done her. Here I send Eva's eye pictures. Well, we did, I think, her husband's.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So this is hers. 60-year-old female, extreme stiffness of the muscles in the shoulder and upper back area with some arthritis. History of varicose veins. So now we know we're into the parathyroid here. Numbness in the hands. That's too much lymph in the shoulders, maybe pulling your spine out. But when the lymph gets, that's that stiffness and tightness you feel in the muscles, that'll suppress nerve flow down the hands and you'll start getting numbness down the hands. Definitely check the spine with the chiropractor to make sure it's in, but at the same time, drain that lymph. And for you, that's good. For you, dear, this story earlier about kinesiology will apply to you. Get and work down your back. Keep working down your back till that stiffness opens up. Hit the kidneys, hit the adrenals, and go down that way. Prone to anxiety attacks, the adrenals, depression, the parathyroid. See how the parathyroid relates to the varicose veins? Absolutely. And angry outbursts, clean your liver out. According to a man who knows about Chinese medicine, Eva's lymph system is overworking. Overworking? It ain't working. Yet I think her adrenal is down. You think? I already brought from your Olga upper circ adrenal formula, kidney capsules. This guy's right on. Endocrine gland. Take something for your lymph system, my friend. You're right on there. Move her lymphs. Okay, so let's look at this. Yeah, hard to see this eye. You need a lot of light in here to see. What do we got, a right eye? Your kidney somewhere in there. Hard to see, sweetheart. But here's groin, here's hip, here's pancreas, here's liver gallbladder, right on up the spectrum. Here's your lung pattern here. Here's your cerebellum up here. Yeah, I need a better picture. Here's your pituitary. Yeah, front forehead. That's just the forehead up there, just right. But that could be an indication. A lot of light, but that could be an indication of a cataract right there. Too hard to see, sweetheart. These eyes are just not good enough for me to see. Too dark.
A little brighter.
A little brighter will do it. All right. Hey, we got through it, Drew. We got through it.
You did good.
I apologize, it's so long to get to some of these, but we put the eye pictures to the side because, you know, this is, it's just, you see how much of a big deal it is, so we just get them all at once. I think I got all of you done. Whoever I missed, especially with your questions, please resubmit them. It's just so much, you know, to get a hold of here, so please be patient with us. If you need to, we hired a bunch of people, so... we should have good phone now and everything, so we really appreciate you guys taking off after your health issues. Word of the day, balance. Don't swing too much on one side and then go to the other side, like David Wolf and poor Dan. Be careful, because that's what you're going to watch. You're going to watch these guys, and then you're going to know what I meant by balance. When you see these guys are real extreme raw foodists, they swing up here, then they swing over there, and they swing over there. I've already done all that. And I did that 40 years ago. So I already know about the swinging. I already know about that. I've been able to keep my life pretty much down the center in balance. But, you know, there's times we got to tear it up. There's times where we got to pull back. But mostly relax. Have fun. Don't let anything bother you. Keep everything out. I promise maybe this weekend, but take those off and have him put it up. Put in a new chip for me, would you, for the weekend, and leave it on here. I'm going to come in and try to do that video on love I promised them, and maybe a little more giddies. All right. I love you all. We love you all. Y'all take care of yourselves. Welcome home. Welcome home. Bye-bye.